The thought of adding insects or other bugs to the menu may not seem that appetizing at the moment, but it could be a great way for people to shrink their carbon footprint and battle climate change.
We're definitely seeing things in our environment that is putting the security of some of our food at risk, right? So if you have major droughts or big fires or torrential rains, all of these put our crops and our various other food sources at risk. And that'll just continue.
More than a third of global greenhouse gas emissions comes from the production, distribution, and consumption of food.
Insects are food for many organisms in the world. So there's been a big push in the last 5 to 10 years to try to expand that so that we are using or exploring the use of insects as an alternative protein source.
Insects could be used to make feed for animals like chickens and cows, or even food for humans.
Insects actually produce protein, right? Insects themselves are protein. And in fact, they're a really valuable source of protein. And the proteins are safe and they are just as nutritious, but they don't destroy the environment quite the way some of our other protein sources do, nor are they necessarily at the mercy of changing climates.
Insects like crickets, ants, and beetles are already a part of a balanced meal in many countries around the globe.
Insects use less water, less land, produce less emissions. So there's all these really beneficial aspects to using insects.
Many bugs are also packed with iron, vitamins, and fat. Researchers say that there are more than 2,000 edible insects in the world, and that's just the ones that have been identified so far. The insects most commonly munched on by humans are beetles, caterpillars, bees, wasps, and ants. But convincing some people to get on board with an insect diet may not be easy.
I'm hopeful one day will be you and me, you know, chowing down on our insects as our protein source, as a supplement. Not necessarily, you know, I'm not saying you have to give up your steaks, but certainly it's a much more environmentally friendly and sustainable practice.
Inside Science. If you enjoyed this edition, follow us on the web and social media. Powered by the American Institute of Physics and a coalition of underwriters.